Hey, Jimmy, you think this is our last flight?
Sure hope so.
You don't sound confident.
One thing about the Nazis, they don't give up so easily.
Airborne, on me. We're going for the knockout punch on this one. If we succeed, we might be home in time for Christmas. Now pay attention. Operation Market Garden requires airborne forces to secure several key bridges on the road to Arnhem. It's a risky plan, one that cannot withstand even the smallest of failures. Our bridge is located in the town of Nijmegen. We must secure the town, then take the bridge. The Germans would rather destroy the bridge and let it fall to us, so we must find and disable any German explosives equipment. Despite heavy Allied bombing, the enemy continues to operate roving armor units. Clear any and all threats from this sector. You are dropping into territory which is firmly in the grip of the enemy. Watch your backs. Dismissed.
Thank you. units. S2 reports the enemy plans to blow the bridge and has hidden demolitions equipment throughout the city. Instructions are to find and sabotage any related apparatus. Within range of this transmission. Instructions are to assemble at the center of town and await further orders.
Ah! convoy's here. Looks like our job's done. Shreks! Come on, Airborne!
Attention all airborne units. Instructions are to eliminate all enemies on the bridge. Use extreme caution when engaging Panzer Shrek teams.
Colonel Scott Webb, commanding officer. This is the after-action report for Operation Market Garden, September 17th, 1944. This was our first daytime jump. As a result, we suffered high casualties. Through fierce fighting, our company accomplished all objectives, ultimately securing the Nijmegen Bridge for armored units moving north toward Arnhem. Captain Campana advises me that during the fighting, Private First Class Boyd Travers distinguished himself by demonstrating great coolness under fire. It is for this reason that I promoted Travers from PFC to corporal. We could use more men like Corporal Travers.